Hi, thanks for joining. My name's Rob, and today I'm going to be taking you through how to add animations to a Flexitive design. So today I'm going to be using the design we built in our previous two videos on building your first size and activating the rest of your sizes. If you haven't had the chance to watch those videos yet, I do recommend jumping back, giving them a view, and then coming back to watch this one. It's going to help out with a couple of the concepts we chat about here. Now, in Flexitive, animations are designed to be fast, easy to add, and scale well to any size. We're gonna be starting with the 300 by 250 here today, but the process is exactly the same no matter what size you're building in. So I'm just gonna jump into the animation panel and then click Start Animating. Now in Flexitive, to make animations easy to use, we've split things up by frames, and each frame is kind of its own stage of your animation sequence. By default, everything in your design is going to be set to be hidden, and your first frame will be 1 second long. Now, we're obviously going to want to change that. So for example, if I want this background to just be visible, I'm just going to select it, and then in the left-hand side canvas of the canvas, you'll see the animation effects panel. And you can set it to either hide, which it is currently, or show. Now, switching it to show is going to make it so it will be visible on this frame. I want this background to be visible here, but because it's my background, I don't necessarily want an entrance animation or anything like that. So I'm just going to set it to show with no animation. Now you can do this for as many different elements per frame as you'd like, with one animation effect per frame per element. So I'm going to select this adaptive bean logo here, and similarly I'll set it to show. But for my logo, I do want this to have an entrance animation. So I'm just going to set this to fade in. You can choose from any of our different entrance animations, as well as a handful of different emphasis animations, which you do have down at the bottom of the canvas. I'm just keeping it as fade in today because it's a pretty straightforward animation that is easy to scale across all my different sizes. So that's all I'm going to do for my first frame. Just going to tap add here to create a second frame. Now, obviously anything that was set to animate in on the previous frame will still be visible here, and I can just continue to click through and add animations to the rest of my elements. So I'll make this coffee cup fade in as well. Add a third frame. On this frame, we'll have my celebrate coffee fade in from below. And you can actually see as I'm adding these animations, in the top right corner, there's this little indicator to tell you what that element is doing on each frame. So for example, I just set this celebrate coffee text to fade in from below. So you have that little indication here. Whereas adaptive bean coffee co and the coffee cup in the background are visible, but not animating. And on this adaptivebean.com call to action, it's actually hidden here. So you'll get a little bit of information on the canvas as you're working as well. Add a fourth frame, and on this frame we'll have the call to action fade in from below as well. And then we'll just add a fifth frame. I'm just going to add a little bit of an emphasis animation to this button here. So scroll down to the bottom of the panel, and you'll see there's all these different emphasis animations to choose from. I'm just going to grab a pulse animation. Now, once I'm happy with this animation sequence, I can actually go back to the first frame by clicking on it and preview the animation sequence by hitting play. And this is going to show me what my animation sequence looks like right now. So that looks pretty good, but I'm going to make a couple quick edits, specifically with the speed and pacing of this animation sequence. So to change the speed and pacing of animations in Flexitive, you're going to want to use these delay and duration toggles in the animation frames panel. So for example, this first frame where my logo fades in, I want this to be a little bit slower. So I'm just going to set the duration of that frame to be 1.5 seconds, which is about 50% slower. Conversely, I want this coffee cup fading in to be really quick, so I'm just going to set this to 0.5 seconds. I'm pretty happy with the celebrate coffee as well as the adaptive bean logo coming in. So I'm just going to set the final frame where the emphasis animation is and the button coming in to have a little bit of a delay of 2 seconds. Set that there. And again, I can preview this animation sequence just by clicking on the first frame, hitting play. There we go. Now, one thing to keep in mind when building your animation sequence is even though this looks really good right now on this size, there could be elements on other sizes, say for example, in my 728 by 90 or my 160 by 600 that are using different elements that aren't currently visible in this 300 by 250. And if you recall from our previous video on activating the rest of your sizes, I actually have a second version of this Adaptive Bean Coffee Co. logo. So I'm gonna jump into my layers panel and set show hidden layers to on. And this is going to make this hidden layer visible for me. And you can see it is actually set right now to be hidden through the entire animation sequence. Now I'm gonna wanna change that. I'm gonna jump into the first frame. This is where my horizontal logo currently is fading in. I'm just going to apply the exact same animation to this stacked logo. So go into the animation effects panel on the left, set it to show. And we'll just have it fade in from above. And while this is hidden on this size, this means that that animation that I just set here is going to propagate to the rest of my sizes as well. Just gonna save my design here quickly. There are a couple more animation effects that I did wanna cover here quickly for you. So I've built out this animation sequence, and if I was to go preview this, it'll look pretty good. But there are some other options as well. So I'm just gonna select my adaptivebean.com call to action here. And in the animation effects panel, you'll see that there's frame and other. Frame is to adjust the animations in the animation sequence, so what we've been doing up until now. Other allows you to add a couple more different animation options. So the most important ones are gonna be this hover state and the animation replay options. We're gonna be going into a little bit more depth in animations in a separate video. But for this video, I just wanted to cover these hover states specifically. So for example, if I wanted to add a hover state of having this pulse, I can just select the pulse option and it'll get added with this duration option. Now, speeding up or slowing down this duration will change how quickly that pulse animation is going to happen when I hover. But what this is going to do is make it so when I preview this animation or I see an exported version of this design, if I was to hover over the adaptivebean.com button, it's going to have that pulsing animation. So I'm just going to save my design really quickly here and jump back out to my all sizes view. And in the all sizes view, I'm going to open up the animation panel again and hit play. And you'll see that all of the different sizes that I've built all have this animation sequence applied to them now. Now this is a really powerful tool in Flexitive. It makes adding animations to your design really fast and really easy and makes it scale across all of your sizes instantaneously. So rather than having to jump into each size, I now have a fully animated HTML5 design across all these different sizes in both fixed and even my responsive sizes as well. So if I go here, hit play, you'll see that here as well. Now that's everything I was looking to cover with animations today. So I'm going to stop here, and in the next video, I'm going to be going into previewing, so taking how we can use these different, all these different sizes that I've built and show you how to create a preview page for them. But until next time, thanks so much for joining, and I hope you have a great day.